himself to our stairs and surprise you?
It sounds mad, but yes.
At the home of one of his 13-year-old pupils? I've half a mind to phone that school.
No, you don't have to. I've had a word with him. He won't be pulling any more stunts like that.
I could not believe I have missed all the fun. So, John-Paul, your new boyfriend?
No, it's not my boyfriend.
Good, because you can do a lot better than that. That John-Paul is a sex pest. Has anyone seen my keys?
Oh, yeah, here. How are you feeling, love?
I don't know if I'm going to walk into a welcome home party or a firing squad. But thanks for the flowers, love. That was so thoughtful.
Just wanted you to know I'd be thinking about you.
Is it safe to open my eyes, or has Steve got another bloke on the stairs?
No, you can come down.
That's a relief. At least won't miss out for life like our Perry.
Oh, yeah, our Perry is going to have to go through years and years of therapy now, isn't she? How do you...
Right, I get it. I'm a dirty pervert, aren't I? But if it was up to me, John Paul won't step foot inside this house again, right?
Ruby, I was...
Hey, what should I do about Carmel?
What about Carmel?
You know, she blames me for giving her an STD. You're not eating that.
Goes all right today, sis.
Take your bat then, sir. Give it here. Hey?
I want you to hand over Mr. Lomax's mobile now.
Sorry, are you accusing me of nicking something?
Empty your pockets.
Be my guest. Do you want me to undo my belt and all for you, sir?
If attacks continue, I'm going to ring the police. Do you understand me?
Cheers. I can't believe you. I thought you'd been given...
Robbie, come on out now.
Finn? I almost didn't recognize you with your kick still on.
Do you have any idea the nightmare your little prank could have caused me? Well, do you? I'm ringing the police.
Oh, Finn, how long does it take you to fix your lip,
mate? Oh, hello. Just cozy.
Robbie, shut it. He said he was going to call the police.
Did he? Go on in, sir. I'm sure they'd love to hear all about you and your little booty call. Mr. Lomax's missus is a copper, isn't she, sir?
This ends now.
Oh, we'll let you know when it ends. Hey, Finn.
Yeah. One word on those faulties at the net.
And don't worry, because we made copies. Now, if you don't mind, sir, I'll come in here to use the facilities.
Oh, yeah.
Where the hell have you been?
Trying to locate Steve, but he's sticking to the story about you and him for now.
So that's it then? I get handcuffed and left half naked and you're worried about Steve blabbing?
Mm-hmm.
Here's your phone. Robbie Roscoe and Finn were behind the whole thing. And it's only a matter of time before they tell the whole world, so you better tell Sam the truth, yeah?
I don't need an ultimatum from you, John Paul.
Have you any idea how humiliated and ashamed I feel?
Look, I'm sorry. I just need more time. Sam's career's on the line.
Oh, Sam's career's on the line. Yeah, why am I even having this conversation with you?
No, listen to me. You stay away from my family, right?
Your family? No, you're just someone they can't get rid of. You know, like herpes.
Oh, how does it feel, eh? To be my dad's little rent boy.
Yeah, yeah, I saw your little personal ad in the paper. Yeah, loser seeks moustached man to knock him about.
What about you? Have you defrocked any priests lately? Or is it married men that you go for now?
Yeah, because I'm going to take morality advice from someone that faked his own daughter's leukemia.
He's got a wife and kids. He doesn't need you messing with that.
Exactly. He has. Why am I the bad guy?
No, do you really think he's going to choose you over Sam? You're pathetic.
No wonder Craig wanted to help you.
Yeah, well, maybe you should have taken your own advice when it came to Doug.
Huh? Right, and what's that supposed to mean?
Well, how does it feel? Knowing that if you'd have left him alone, he might still be alive.
Now that is your last warning. You stay away. Oi!
50 quid says Deli Boy kicks Grangell's back.
Oi! Hey!
Oh my God, Steve!
Oh, come on then!
Get off him!
Pack it in the barrier!
Stay away from him or you come through me first.
I thought he was your fella.
All right, can everyone just calm down, all right? Now, look, whatever the problem is, street fighting like a cat of fire.
Oh, shut up, right? Leave me alone.
Steve.
You deserve someone that can give you everything you want.
You are everything I have ever.
In that case, then, I'll phone Dodger, see if he'll take me out for a drink.
Through this. And today wasn't your fault, okay?
You're right. This isn't my fault.
What do you want?
To thank you. Not telling Sam the truth last night. And I'm sorry for what I said about Doug.
Yeah, well, you're right. I have done bad things as well. But I have never tried to break a family apart just because I can.
Oh, what, you think I don't hate myself for being strung along by your dad?
Right, so just walk away then.
What if I can't? Supposed to be a flying visit. Now I'm back where it all began. School running scared.
Why don't you just finish with my dad?
Because I love him. And I know he loves me too.
I want it closer to your eye. It'll stop the swelling.
You were right what you said before. When it comes to me and men and making mistakes, I wrote the book.
I only just clocked onto that.
Well, you can hardly talk. Brendan Brady?
No. I married Doug, didn't I? He knew we was going to move away together.
You must really miss him.
I do. And you haven't got a clue about Brendan either. I loved him. Still love him.
Sorry.
Blame you for falling for me, Dad.
How can you? I mean, you almost went there.
But mind if we don't. Look, being with Brendan, I saw what hiding the truth can do. It can hurt a family, and I just want my dad to be happy.
And all the biggest surprises. Me being back here or you. Wearing chinos and selling smoothies.
Sisters. Yeah, I like Sam. They don't deserve any of this. Yeah.
Thanks. Since Craig, he's the first person I've met that I thought I could actually be happy with.
You do know that he won't choose you though, don't you? Because he loves Sam too much.
If you could go through it all again with Brendan and Doug,
Would you let it go?
You know what? I was frightened at first about living in his old house. Being there. Sleeping there, it's nice. It does make me feel closer to him.
He talked about you that night, you know, that I met him in Ireland.
And what did he say?
He'd met someone that loved him. And that he finally felt happier than he'd ever been. But he was scared. He was scared because he knew he'd let you down.
He really said that.
He really loved you, you know.
I know.
Yeah. At least he was taken from you. Craig walked out on me.
Yeah, but at least you've had your chance. Now all I'm left with is what ifs.
Well, I guess that's what we've got in common then, isn't it? We're both alone.